Good evening, Hampton University. My name is Elias James Fambro, a graduating senior accounting major from Rockford, Illinois, and I'd love to introduce you to the 2020 annual Miss Black and Gold Scholarship Pageant. As I speak on behalf of the chapter, we'd love to say that we are extremely grateful that in the midst of it all, we were still able to put on an amazing pageant with these 9 beautiful, amazing women. We hope you're at home, quarantined, staying safe, and ready to enjoy the pageant we have for you today. Let's meet the contestants.
Contestant number 1.
Good evening, Hampton University. My name is Tatum Cassidy Morris, a second year political science major from Woodbury, Minnesota. A quote that I live by is, if you want to be original, be ready to be copied, by Coco Chanel. My platform is called Culture Contortion, bending our conscious and unconscious biases in order to make genuine change. Thank you.
Contestant number 2.
Good evening, Hampton University. I am Mayana Elise Mabry, a junior political science major on the pre-law track from Greenville, North Carolina. A quote that I live by is, if you do what you love, you'll never have to work a day in your life, by Mark Anthony. My platform is Embrace, inspiring our youth to embody their disabilities. Thank you.
Contestant number 3.
Good evening, Hampton University. I am Amanda Pamela McDaniels, a graduating senior business management major from the one and only Dreamville, Fayetteville, North Carolina. A quote I live my life by is, I had to make my own living and my own opportunity, but I made it. Don't sit down and wait for the opportunities to come. Get up and make them, Madam CJ Walker. And my platform is Kobe, creating opportunity for Black youth through networking and educational events. Thank you.
Contestant number 4.
Greetings, Hampton University, family, friends, and to the members of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. My name is Courtney Michelle Parker, a junior political science major on the pre-law track with a minor in Russian language from Woodbridge, Virginia. A quote that I live my life by is, in a gentle way, you can shake the world, by Gandhi. My platform is sparking languages in minorities, not only heightening the awareness of the need of African Americans within critical languages such as Russian, Mandarin, and Arabic, but also exposing minority youth to these critical languages and culture. Thank you.
Contestant number 5.
Good evening, Hampton University. I am Ayana Iman Evans, a graduating senior journalism major, entrepreneurship minor from the windy city of Chicago, Illinois. A quote I live by is, think like a queen. For a queen is not afraid to fail. Failure is another stepping stone to greatness. Oprah Winfrey. And my platform is Slay, self-love and empowerment, with a mission to shatter unattainable beauty standards in our society. Thank you.
Contestant number 6.
Good evening, Hampton University. I am Jada Renee Graham, a graduating senior biology major on the pre-dental track, hailing from the Charm City, Baltimore, Maryland. A quote I live by is by former First Lady Michelle Obama. Success is not measured by the money we make, but by the difference we make in people's lives. My platform is Project HBCU, encouraging Black youth to attend institutions established with them in mind. Thank you.
Contestant number 7.
Greetings, Hampton University. My name is Amber Nicole Anderson, a second year strategic communications major, leadership studies minor from the windy city of Chicago, Illinois. A quote I live my life by is, the ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands in times of challenge and controversy, by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. My platform is Each One, Teach One, empowering young Black men through career and college readiness, mentorship, and mental health awareness. Thank you.
Contestant number 8.
Good evening, Hampton University. I am Tredell Precious Lynn Baker, a sophomore journalism major from the Summit City, Fort Wayne, Indiana. A quote that I live my life by is, not everything that is faced can be changed, but nothing can be changed until it is faced, by James Baldwin. My platform is Built, Brothers United in Learning Tenacity Against Mental Health Struggles and Systematic Racism. Thank you.
Contestant number 9.
Good evening, Hampton University. My name is Waikila Peace Bashir, and I'm a graduating senior journalism major from the home of the Whitney Elizabeth Houston, Newark, New Jersey. A quote that I live my life by is, failure is not the opposite of success, it is a part of it, by Arianna Huffington. My platform, Sisters at Key, mission is to implement the importance of money management and entrepreneurship in the African American community. Thank you.
Before we move on for tonight, let's meet some of our phenomenal judges.
Judge number 1.
John Harvey IV is a fifth-year, five-year MBA major at Hampton University. He is a spring 2019 initiate into the Gamma Iota chapter of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. John was born and raised in Washington, D.C. He is an avid reader and is very passionate about encouraging others to read themselves in order to enlighten and unshackle the black mind from the prison of Eurocentrism and white supremacy. His ultimate goal in life is to gain generational wealth for his family. He seeks to achieve this goal by managing multiple streams of income and starting his own business.
Judge number 2.
As a proud Hamptonian, Sini J. Bellamy is a graduate of Hampton University, QT5, and a former employee for more than 20 years. A native of Hampton, Virginia, Sini currently serves as an assistant director of enrollment support services at William & Mary. Ms. Bellamy believes in God, love, and family. In accordance with that mantra, she also serves as an associate minister at Genesis Christian Fellowship Church in Newport News, Virginia. An avid lover of dance, Sini proudly serves as the head of the liturgical dance ministry at her church. In addition, Sini actively participates in community outreach activities that include, but are not limited to, mentoring youth and teaching in nursing homes. Sini is the wife of Brother Michael A. Bellamy of the Delta Beta Lambda chapter of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. She is also a mother of three and a proud grandmother to Skylar, Willis, and Julian.
This is going to be an amazing pageant. The next portion of the pageant is swimwear. Contestants will be judged based on these following components: the swimwear of choice, the self-confidence, and the poise.
Contestant number 1.
Turn the lights off in this place, and she shines just like a star. And I swear I know her face, I just don't know who you are. Turn the music up in here, I still hear her loud and clear, like she's right there in my ear, telling me that she wants to own.
Contestant number 2. Contestant number 3.
I can feel her on my skin, I can taste her on my tongue. She's the sweetest taste of sin. The more I get, the more I want. She wants to own me. Come closer, she says, come closer.
Contestant number 4.
And I just can't bring myself no way, but I don't want.
Contestant number 5. Contestant number 6. Contestant number 7. Same old song, no. But I was so sure that it wouldn't happen to me, cause I know how to put it down. But I was so wrong. This girl with me, so she really. My body was so tight, I'm looking for right in the daytime with the flashlight. Contestant number 8. Contestant number 9.
Absolutely gorgeous. Let's move on to meet some more of our judges.
Judge number 3.
Cameron Abney is a 2017 graduate of Hampton University and has had the distinct honor of serving Hampton University as our Mr. Pirate 2016-2017. Cameron Abney is a fall 2014 initiate into the Gamma Iota chapter of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. Since graduation, he relocated to Atlanta, Georgia, where he began his career as a management consultant with Accenture. He has celebrated 2 promotions in his 3 years with the company, including that his most recent promotion to consultant as of December 1st. He also celebrates his 1-year anniversary as an entrepreneur with his company, Cooper Bottle. Taste the difference of true hydration, real alkaline water.
Judge number 4.
Ms. Christina N. James, a native of Williamsport, Pennsylvania, currently serves as one of the assistant directors of student activities here at Hampton University. Ms. James is a graduate of Shippensburg University of Pennsylvania, where she studied communications and journalism with a concentration in public relations. While in school, her involvement on campus in organizations such as the Activities Program Board, Alpha Phi Omega, PRSSA, Homecoming Committee, and union programming are what led her down the path of student activities. Her love for student activities did not go unnoticed. Ms. James was presented with the National Association for Campus Activities Award of Outstanding Student Leader in the Mid-Atlantic Region in 2016. You can now find her here working with the members of the Greer Dawson Wilson Student Leadership Training Program, CIO, the junior class, as well as clubs and organizations. Ms. James serves as a staff facilitator of the annual Mr. Pirate Pageant and a co-staff facilitator for the Miss Hampton University Scholarship Pageant, giving her a good understanding of the judging process. She lives by the Bible verse, Samuel 22:33. It is God who arms me with strength and keeps my way secure.
Judge number 5.
Brother Fred Scott is a native of Richmond, Virginia. He is the current president, district director of the Virginia Association of Chapters of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. He is a life member and 39-year member of the fraternity, where he crossed at the Gamma Iota chapter, Hampton University, in 1981. Brother Scott received his bachelor's from Hampton University and a master's degree from Columbia University. In his professional career, he currently serves as a senior business education consultant for PowerSchool Incorporation, promoting the best practices in talent management solutions. Brother Scott spent 33 years in K-12 education as a teacher, curriculum specialist, technology manager, and staff developer. He has won awards in his profession and the fraternity, as well as presented hundreds of professional development sessions to people across the country. Brother Fred Scott has served his fraternity and profession for years, with the emphasis on empowered all to value education and the impact we provide our global society. He is married to his childhood best friend, Paulette, and they have two children, Neil and Whitney.
Okay, let's move on. You know, I hear the ladies have a lot of talents up their sleeve. I'm just as curious as y'all are to see what type of talents they bring.
Contestant number 1.
George Floyd, Michael Brown. As we change laws, the police find ways around a peculiar institution. The 13th Amendment, what did it change? Nothing but more of our men in chains. A peculiar institution. Our non-black supporters must turn from allies to advocates, but it is clear that they are not the only ones who are complicit. We don't like black women, black on black crime, the overwhelming failure to support our businesses with even a dime. The tragedy of light-skinned blacks versus dark-skinned blacks, there is something, clearly something, that this community lacks.
The main skill needed to juggle a ball is focus. It is the same needed to bend the culture of our institution, though some fail to notice. Once we focus on ourselves and where we go wrong,
we'll realize that what's been keeping this institution so peculiar has been us all along.
Contestant number 2.
Some people want diamond rings, some chains. want everything, but everything means nothing if I ain't got you.
Contestant number three. Contestant number four.
Hurry! They're waiting on you. You didn't know? The past, the present, the future, they're waiting on you. All our ancestors ask is that you remember your past. Gold, like the skin of my wealthy ancestors who were sold and forced onto slave ships to a country that they built with their sweat that claimed democracy but exemplified years of dictatorship. An everlasting thank you to the ones who fought for my rights to vote, get an education, and simply sit on a bus. And that's why remembering you with every entity of my life is a must. And although you face many altercations, confrontations, separations, and bear the nauseating taste and atrocious face of discrimination, that was your way of lifting every voice and praying for us. 40 seconds have gone by, and they're still waiting on you. To my beautiful black women, do they hate our skin or do they admire our melanin? They want you to hate every sway of your hip, but yet they are desirous of our cheekbones and lips, so which one is it? My black kings, you are inherently royal. So to all my Chadwick Bosemans, Martin Luther Kings, and Malcolm X's, please continue to use your purpose to be a blessing. A minute has gone by, and they're still waiting on you. The future's developed and innovated, but does it have your legacy? Did you do something to shape it, or did you leave it breathlessly like Ahmaud Arbery, George Floyd, Elijah McClain, Neil Williams, or Breonna Taylor? May they all rest in peace. May your ambitions and dreams rest in myself and everyone who looks like me. My time is up, but they're still waiting on you.
Contestant number five.
What if a black girl knew that she would be desired by others only if she desired herself? That beauty is not a shade, but a mindset, and the best indicator of it is self-confidence. But what if a black girl knew that her lips were plump and beautiful, and she does not need to hold them in, make them thin? But what if a black girl knew that there is no such thing as a perfect nose, because a nose is not meant to be perfect, it is meant to help you breathe, and if you can breathe, black girl, then you've succeeded. But what if a black girl knew that history recorded her to be the most sought after? She was that same creature that drove slave masters from wicked hate right down to love by the curves in her figure eight. Figure out, black girl, figure out. The figures match years of social degrading delivered from the black girl's demise. What if a black girl knew that life is what you make of it, opportunities are what you take from it? What if a black girl knew that change is possible, greatness is personal, and although it is black girls at the bottom of the social totem pole, pressure makes diamonds. So it is time, black girls, to let your diamonds glow.
Contestant number six. Contestant number 6.
If you feel insignificant, you better think again. Better wake up because you're part of something way bigger. You're part of something way bigger. Not just a speck in the universe. Not just some words in a Bible verse. You are the living word. Ah, you're part of something way bigger. Bigger than you, bigger than we. Bigger than the picture they framed us to see. But now we see it. And it ain't no secret. You just don't know yet. You just don't know it yet. No matter how hard it gets, you got my blood in ya, and you're gonna rise. You're part of something way bigger. You're part of something way bigger. Bigger than you, bigger than me. Bigger than the picture that painted us to be.
Contestant number 7.
The most disrespected person in America is the black woman. The most unprotected person in America is the black woman. The most neglected person in America is the black woman.
The most disrespected person in America is the black woman. The most unprotected person in America is the black woman. The most neglected person in America is the black woman. Even while being the most disrespected, we push for people in this world to respect you. We push for people to call you by your name instead of son, boy, or even a slur. We push for you to be known as someone other than the black kid who's the basketball star. We push so that you can pull up the next generation of young black men. Even while being the most unprotected person in America, we risk our lives to protect our community and you at all costs. We leave ourselves in a state of vulnerability so that you can feel secure. Even while being the most neglected person in America, we choose to be nurturers. We choose to be both mothers and fathers. We choose to water others as we often run out of water for ourselves. Black women serve as your biggest advocates, while we often have no one to advocate for us. We are not built to be superwoman. We are human just like you. Black men, take the time to push us up just as much as we choose to push you all up. Use your strength and your talents to advocate for black women. Push for us to not be known just as the angry black woman or the loud black girl. Push for us to succeed in the classroom, the courtroom, and the boardroom. Push for us so that we can bring up the next generation of young black women.
Contestant number 8.
Let me convey this in the simplest form. You are not okay. Every day you suppress your emotions. Every day you push back self-care. Every day you answer a question with, I'm good, but I haven't seen a good day in far too long. Stop lying. I love you most, black man, because you are a reflection of me. You allow me to see the discrepancies, what lies in between. So I can stop lying in between what society tells me and what feels to me. Because every time I turn on my TV screen, all I see is you dying. Then I start crying. Because I love you most, baby. Society wants you to fail. Their devices trip you up, but you never stumble. You never fumble. You never... Until you did. You deserve better, black man. You are valued and loved. You matter, black man. And I'm sorry you don't get told enough. Look up, but don't come back down. Because I'll always be around as your angel.
Contestant number 9.
Is that you? Boy, am I glad to see you. With all the craziness and uncertainty going on in the world, I sure hope that you all are blessed and that you're being safe during these trying times. My name is Joaquin Lapeace Bashir, and I am your late night talk show host. I don't plan to keep you all for long tonight, but there is something I would like to share with y'all, something that I'm passionate about, generational wealth. What is generational wealth? A long-term income that lasts for generations. I mean, who wouldn't want that for their family? Let's date back to 1906, when the Black Wall Street was created in the Greenwood District in Tulsa, Oklahoma. This community was full of Black-owned businesses, pharmaceuticals, restaurants, doctor's offices. Anything you could think of, they had it. Unfortunately, in 1921, this all came to an end. But we won't go into too much detail on that, but what we will do is fast forward to 2020. Today, we have 637,000 Black-owned businesses, and your girl is a Black business owner herself. I own a t-shirt brand, True to You, the brand that empowers. My mission is to empower the African-American community, men and women. Now, this is me starting my generational wealth. We all need to empower one another so that we can reclaim our Black Wall Street. This has been the Late Night Talk Show with your host, Waqila Peace Bashir. Make sure you all go out to vote. Thank you and good night.
I hope you all have been enjoying the pageant as much as I am. The next portion of the pageant is formal wear. Contestants will be judged based on these following components: confidence, style, and poise.
Your contestant number one is Tatum Cassidy Morris. Tatum entered Hampton University with sophomore year credits and is now in her second year as a political science major. She is the daughter of Scott and Sabrina Morris and is from Woodbury, Minnesota. During her first year, Tatum was in the Freshman Honors Program and the social media chair of the Midwest Pre-Alumni Council. This year, she is one of the executive assistants in the 75th administration of the Student Government Association's cabinet. She also participates in the social media chair for the Political Science Club and is an active member of the student recruitment team. Tatum has held internships in the Minnesota Governor's Office of Diversity and Inclusion and as a social media diversity intern for Novita PR in New York. Her platform, Culture Contortion, Bending Our Conscious and Unconscious Biases in Order to Make Genuine Change, acknowledges the importance of reforming and replacing law and policy in our institutions for the furtherment of the Black community, but emphasizes the need of confronting and contorting personal mindsets that are potentially regressive for the Black community. Tatum hopes that through culture contortion, non-Black supporters can turn from allies to advocates, and for the Black community itself to create a culture centered around Black acceleration versus Black assimilation. Your contestant number two is Mayanna Elise Mabry, a native of Greenville, North Carolina. At the age of 4, Mayanna was diagnosed with juvenile rheumatoid arthritis, which left her homebound in a wheelchair, presumably for the rest of her life. She promised herself to learn how to walk and retaught herself how to walk by the age of 13. Her perseverance through all her hardships with a physical disability is what inspired her platform, Embrace, inspiring our youth to embody their disabilities. Mayanna lives by the quote, "If you do what you love, you'll never have to work a day in your life," by Mark Anthony. Mayanna genuinely enjoys being involved on campus and is an honor student. Mayanna holds more than 7 leadership positions on campus, including her role as founder and president of Politics, an action-based organization she started for students to get involved politically. She is also an endowed scholar in the National Hampton Alumni Association, Incorporated, emerging leader in the Gloucester Institute Emerging Leaders Program, member of the Freddie T. Davey Honors College, and she was recently accepted into the Greer Dawson Wilson Student Leadership Training Program. Mayanna hopes that with her platform, she can work closely with disabled youth in the Hampton Roads community and help them fulfill their life aspiration and defy the odds. Your contestant number three is Amanda Pamela McDaniels. Amanda is from North Carolina. She is the eldest child and first daughter of Celeste and Myron McDaniels. As a soon-to-be graduating senior at Hampton University, Amanda is a member of Queen and You, Sisters Inspiring Sisters, Society for Advancement of Management, and the Student Recruitment Team. Amanda was nominated as a 2020 Johns Hopkins Business Scholar. Realizing that she has had these opportunities at Hampton University and beyond, Madam C.J. Walker's famous quote, "I had to make my own living and my own opportunity.
but I made it. Don't sit down and wait for the opportunities to come. Get up and make them. Inspired Amanda to provide multiple opportunities to Black youth so that they too can achieve their passions. Your contestant number four is Courtney Michelle Parker, a junior political science major on the pre-law track with a minor in Russian language from Woodbridge, Virginia. Courtney Parker is dedicated to her mission of uplifting those around her. Courtney has been on the dean's list since her freshman year at Hampton University. During Courtney's time at Hampton University, she has been a proud member of College Girls, where she currently serves as a social media ambassador, Service Bree Incorporated as a tutor for middle school students, the Hampton University chapter of the Good Girl Movement as the event co-chair, historian of the Pre-Law Society, and the vice president of the HU chapter of Phi Alpha Delta Law Fraternity Incorporated. Courtney created her nonprofit organization, Sparking Languages and Minorities, in 2019 to encourage the idea that learning a language can open multiple doors for a child of color, such as scholarship, opportunities, career endeavors, and overall financial stability. Courtney's favorite Bible verse is Romans 8:31. If God is for us, who can be against us? Your contestant number five is determined, focused, and driven. These are just a few of the attributes of Ayana Iman Evans, a graduating senior, journalism major, and entrepreneurship minor from Chicago, Illinois. Throughout her years at Hampton University, Ayana has sharpened her creative interests by working for the student-run newscast WHOV-TV and Her Campus, a digital magazine for women. Ayana's leadership roles include serving as co-leader for Impressions of Beauty and as a historian for the New Era Modeling Troupe. With a heart for service, Ayana created the platform SLAE, which stands for Self, Love, and Empowerment. The purpose is to empower young girls to love themselves by defying traditional beauty standards. Ayana is currently a social media intern for TikTok. Upon graduation, Ayana will take on the world of entertainment and has already been offered a lucrative position with a worldwide marketing agency. Your contestant number six is Jada Renee Graham, currently a senior studying biology on the pre-dental track from Baltimore, Maryland. Since arriving at Hampton, Jada has made great contributions to her academic success and extracurricular organizations. Jada has a 3.68 cumulative GPA and also has been on the dean's list every semester at Hampton. Outside of her academic career, Jada participates and holds leaderships in a variety of on-campus organizations and academic honor societies. Because of Jada's passion for advocacy and increasing enrollment at historically Black colleges and universities, she founded her platform, Project HBCU, in 2018, a nonprofit that shows high school students the educational and social value of attending HBCUs. Through Project HBCU, Jada has spoken to over 500 high school students in both the Baltimore and Hampton Roads community by hosting seminars and assisting them with their application process. She believes that as an HBCU student, it is her duty to highlight the lifelong benefits of those institutions while providing students with the resources to succeed. Her future includes earning a Doctor of Dental Surgery degree and specializing in pediatric public health dentistry. She plans to open various dental clinics in underserved areas and advocate on public policy concerning dental health care. She also plans to continue to work through Project HBCU as a lifelong advocate for higher education in the Black community. Your contestant number seven is Amber Anderson. Amber is a second year strategic communications major, leadership studies minor from Chicago, Illinois. She is a trailblazer on a mission to inspire and empower Black women and girls throughout the United States. Having witnessed the tremendous impact of her parents, both of who are educators, on youth, she developed her own passion for community work and education, which has fueled her own endeavors. Since 2017, she has served as the executive director and founder of the Black is Gold organization, NFP, a peer mentoring group for Black women and girls. She is very active on Hampton University's campus, serving as a 2020-21 Miss Sophomore, event chair for Her Campus, president of Black is Gold Hampton University chapter, an active member of Women's Caucus, and a William R. Harvey Leadership Institute Fellow. A quote that she lives her life by is, "The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of convenience and comfort, but where he stands at times of challenge and controversy," by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. She hopes to impact the lives of young Black men through her platform, Each One Teach One, empowering young Black men through career and college readiness, mentorship, and mental health awareness. Your contestant number 8 is Shardell Baker. She is a native of Fort Wayne, Indiana. She is the daughter of Sherelle Mims Baker and Wendell Baker. While navigating her second year, despite the COVID-19 pandemic, she has prided herself on the survival of the organizations that she is involved in through social media. These organizations include Her Campus Hampton U, Black is Gold University, Hustle U Magazine, and the Student Recruitment Team. Shardell's scholastic achievements include being a scholarship recipient through the organizations of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, Incorporated, Zeta Phi Beta Sorority, Incorporated, the Martin Luther King Club of Fort Wayne, and she is currently a student on the Dean's List. She lives life by the quote, "Not everything that is faced can be changed, but nothing can be changed until it is faced," by James Baldwin. This mindset, along with her passion for Black men's mental health, is what propelled her to create her platform, BUILT, Brothers United in Learning Tenacity, against mental health struggles and systematic racism. It is Shardell's hope that her platform will help African-American men strive for excellent mental health and expand their horizon through genuine connections and mentorship. Your contestant number 9 is Wakila Peace Bashir. Wakila is a native of Newark, New Jersey. She is the youngest daughter of Egina Peace. Wakila transferred from West Essex County College in 2018. During her matriculation at the community college, she was inducted into the National Society for Leadership and Success while maintaining a 3.7 GPA. During her attendance at Hampton University, she has made the Dean List for 3 consecutive semesters. Apart from her academics, Wakila is also active in the Hampton University community and campus life. Wakila serves as the Health Committee Chair for the NAACP. She serves as the Community Service Chair on the e-board of Hampton University's first American Sign Language Club. She also worked as a student worker at Hampton University's radio station Smooth 88.1, WHOV. Throughout Wakila's journey, she always relied on Philippines 4:13 for guidance. "I can do all things through him who strengthens me." Through this scripture, Wakila was able to apply the same influence of those in her community. Wakila's platform, Sisters in Key, was created to help implement the importance of money management and entrepreneurship in the African-American community, along with engaging in community outreach. Wakila hopes to expand her organization so that she can provide for those not only in her community in Newark, New Jersey, but in communities across the world.
Before we crown a new Miss Black and Gold, we absolutely cannot forget to pay homage to our 2019-2020 title holder, Miss Martine Augustine. And for our final portion of the contest, contestants will be asked a series of important questions. This is our most challenging portion of the evening. Let's welcome our 2019-2020 Miss Black and Gold, Miss Martine Augustine, for questioning.
Good evening, Tatum.
Good evening, Martine.
What makes you unique?
Thank you for that question, Martine. What makes me unique is my skill set. I enjoy fashion. I can do hair. I'm athletic. I can run a mile really quickly. I can cook. I can bake. But most importantly, I am intelligent. I'm proficient in Spanish. And I am so good at analyzing social issues, and this is something that I will be able to use in a career later in life. Thank you.
Thank you. What is your biggest, what is the biggest mistake you have ever made in your life? What have you done to overcome it?
Thank you for that question, Martine. One of the biggest mistakes that I have made in my life was the failure to embrace my Blackness. From K through 12, I went to a predominantly white school, and I was almost embarrassed to be who I really am because people always made fun of me for being different. Thankfully now, I embrace all the great things that make me unique and cherish those, and there is absolutely no one else that I would want to be. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, Mayana.
Good evening, Martine.
How do you handle peer pressure?
Thank you for that question, Martine. How I handle peer pressure is that I remind myself of my core values, and whatever I am being pressured to do, if that goes against what I strongly believe in, I simply say no. Thank you.
Thank you. President of the United States, how would you handle such an event?
Thank you for that question, Martine. If I were president of the United States, I will handle a lot of things differently, such as the way that our law enforcement system is, such as working towards equality for women or everybody who is not a white man in America. And I would just handle things completely different than what we are currently used to. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, Amanda.
Good evening, Martine.
What are your thoughts on abortion and a woman's right to choose?
Thank you for that question, Martine. When it comes to abortion, I feel that we need more versatile women when it comes to the legal conversations about a woman's body. It could become disheartening to see so many men make a decision about a woman's body. I also think it's important to support whatever a woman chooses to do with her body. Thank you.
Thank you. Do you think the swimsuit round is derogatory?
Thank you for that question, Martine. Although there are stereotypes about the swimsuit round in pageants, I do not see that it can be derogatory. I think it's a great opportunity for women to show off another side of their fashion sense. And it's also a great opportunity to embrace all body types from different women. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, Courtney.
Good evening, Martine.
What is the essence of being a woman?
Thank you for that question. I believe that the essence of being a woman is celebrating your femininity, stepping into your voice, and making sure that your voice is heard to help your community, your friends, your family in the best way possible.
Thank you. Is technology hurting our communication skills?
Thank you for that question. I believe that technology is not hurting our communication skills. However, our society must remember that it is extremely important to always have face-to-face conversations and make sure that we know how to communicate with each other face-to-face in all different entities. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, Ayana.
Good evening, Martine.
Do you think our elected government officials should be held accountable for the bad decisions they make? How?
Thank you for that question. Yes, I do believe that elected officials should be prosecuted for the bad decisions that they make because we voted them and they need to be for the people because the people elected them. Thank you.
Thank you. Do beauty pageants help or hurt society's views of women?
Thank you for that question. I believe that beauty pageants help the way society views a woman because they showcase her talent, her beauty, her confidence, and her achievements. With that being said, the women that are chosen for this are beautiful and they have miles and miles of things ahead of them. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, Jada.
Good evening, Martine.
If you had 30 seconds to say anything to our political leaders, what would you say?
Thank you for that question. If I had 30 seconds to say anything to our political leaders, I would tell them that we are holding them accountable and to continue to fight and push for progressive policy change. Thank you.
Thank you. Tell us about your biggest weaknesses.
Thank you for that question. One of my biggest weaknesses, is my desire for perfection. But I have learned that there is perfection in imperfection. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, Amber.
Good evening, Martin.
Do you think women are given the same opportunities as men in America?
Thank you for that question. I do not believe that women are given the same opportunities as men in our country.
Thank you. To a woman who has been asleep for 20 years, what would you say she has missed?
Thank you for that question. To a woman who has been asleep for the past 20 years, I would say that she has missed everything that has happened in history and the way that we have advanced as a world and as a country as a whole being in America. I would say she's missed the technology advancements. She's also missed some very important moments in history, especially a time right now, including COVID.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, Sherdell.
Good evening, Martine.
Would you say that you are a good role model?
Thank you for that question, Martine. Yes, I would say that I'm a good role model because I exude confidence in all the things that I do. In addition to this, I do my best to be positive towards others and be encouraging in times where they are feeling low. Thank you.
Thank you. Where do you see yourself in 10 years?
Thank you for that question, Martine. Where I see myself in 10 years would be successful and looking to impact others with mental health. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening, Wakila.
Good evening, Martine.
What makes you different from the other girls competing today?
Thank you for that question, Martine. What makes me different from the other contestants is my platform, Sisters in Key, which implements the money management and entrepreneurship in African-American communities. Thank you.
Thank you. If you could teach a new class in school, what would it be?
Thank you for that question, Martine. If I could teach any class in the school, it would be African-American studies. The reason why is because I don't feel as though we get enough of our history taught to us from K through 12 and even college. So if there was a course that I would teach, it would be African-American studies. Thank you.
Thank you.
Before we crown the new Miss Black and Gold, as the chair of this pageant, I would just like to say thank you. Thank you, ladies, for your hard work and your efforts. They have made this pageant more than anything that I could ever imagine. Thank you to the co-chair of this pageant, my brother Bruce. Thank you for everything that you've done for this pageant. And a special thank you to our pageant directors, Courtney Penn and Aaliyah Bell. Without you two, this pageant could not have went anywhere that it did. Thank you for your hard work. Thank you. All right, the scores are in. Are you ready for the results? Miss Scholarship is Jada Graham. Miss Photogenic is Amber Anderson. Miss Congeniality is Mayana Mabry. Miss Fundraiser is Jada Graham. And what we've all been waiting for, Miss 1947 is Gamma Iota is and the 2020-2021 Miss Black and Gold is